Hello, YouTubers.
Well, I've got the changer out of the cabinet, and I've just been looking at it here, and I noticed some weird stuff going on here. First of all, this thing is loose.
Oh, you poor baby.
So, I figured, well, it's got to have some, those grommets are rotten, but that doesn't seem to be the case here. So, let me show you what the other side looks like. Now, this is the original changer, and I'm not going to use this one. The other one seems to be in better condition, and this was quite a chore taking this platter off. And I'm going to show you that on the newer one. But in the meantime here, I wanted to show you this. The motor here is kind of loose like this.
What, the Riddler loose too?
So it seems.
The grommets are not rotten or anything. I don't know if these are the correct grommets or not.
Loose to plague us with his criminal conundrums.
But just let me show you here. I'm pushing up on the motor from the bottom. And you can see, the top of the sleeve here and the bottom of the grommet here, there's a gap here.
Aha!
So when I put this washer on here and put the nut on it, there's that gap. You see this?
Yes.
And that's the way all of them are. So when this is setting down here, it kind of just, it falls down. I don't know if that's the way it's supposed to be or not. I'm going to check the other one to see if that's the same way, but the only thing that holds this down is gravity because of the weight of the motor. So that's something we want to take a look at on the other changer, and let's do that right now. This is the other changer. In fact, this one's in a lot better shape than the other one that was in the other cabinet, except for this, it's got some scratchy paint here. So I may use this and take the tone arm off the other one and put it on this one. But let me show you here. I'm going to take this off. Now, to take this off, there's a screw on the bottom right here. All right. Loose, so this should come up, but you gotta be very, very careful, and I'll show you why. That's why. Another great design by Philco.
My balls are gone. I lost my balls.
Can you believe that? There's 11 ball bearings here, and you're just sitting in there. Unbelievable. Okay, now this looks different. Looks like this rubber comes up a lot higher. But you're still playing it.
Shall we play another rubber?
Take one of these out and see what happens here.
对不起, 您输入的密码不正确。
Let's take them all out.
I'm sick of this!
Well, I'm fed up too. I'm sick of the whole thing too.
Same sleeves as the other one. But I really don't think these are the original. Somebody put those in there, I believe. And they're too short, is what I'm thinking. Of course, I got half a grain, so what do I know? Here's the idler reel.
How does that feel, baby?
Actually, it feels soft, so I don't know if that's been changed. Well, I believe that should be up like that. And there's just too much of a gap here. From here to the bottom of here should be more rubber. Or else it's just floating around like that. Is that possible they made it like that?
Don't ask me, I don't know.
I can put a grommet on here.
Don't be ridiculous, Chumley.
Seems a lot more sturdy that way. Let's try one all the way around.
That's the most outstanding answer I've ever heard. You must have a goddamn IQ of 160.
Now, will that seem more stable?
Oh, brother. Oh, brother.
It's still flexible, but, this doesn't move because it's one fixed speed. Seems like it would be quieter too. Maybe I'm all wet, but I'm gonna try it like that. There's the idler wheel. Let's take it out and see what it looks like.
Take a gander.
Come on, man, give me a look. Let me take a peek.
This needs closer examination. In fact, it needs a nightgown.
Feels okay. I'm gonna repack those bearings there. It says you can use grease or like Vaseline, but I'm gonna use this white lithium grease.
Heavens to Murgatroyd!
Get enough grease on there and the bearings won't fall out.
Alright, hold on. When I try and find my balls, for God's sakes. One, two.
That's the most amazing thing I ever saw. Yeah.
Great balls of fire!
Does this seem weird to any of you people out there?
I know you are, but what am I?
Because, sure does to me.
You really asking for trouble, fella.
Okay, we got that in there. Put some grease here. And this goes here.
Work.
I got this idler wheel I gotta move in here.
Success.
All right, let's see if I can lock that from the bottom and we'll try it out. Okay, this is the original Shure cartridge. This hasn't been opened. This is not the one I rebuilt. This is the one that just tested good right off. So we're going to try this. And I lubed the bottom of this changer. So let's see how it sounds. Okay, before we begin the tests, I ordered a 35 L6 instead of the 50 L6 that was in there. So this is the original tube that it was designed for. So I'm going to use the original. What we're going to do here is test the three different cartridges. The first one up is the original Shure cartridge, which is working. The second one will be the piezo element that I rebuilt. And the third will be a modern ceramic cartridge. And this is, we're going to just see which sounds the best, okay? That should make Ray from New York happy.
Hello.
Because he's been bugging me that you gotta have the new ceramic one. Well, you know, if this original one sounds good compared to the other ones, I'm gonna use it. So we'll just test all three. Which one will buzz embrace? Well, we're gonna let old Blue Eyes decide, because we're gonna play his song, Embraceable You, on each cartridge. Here is the first one, the Shure cartridge. Sounds pretty good. I'm going to flip this on the tone and see if the tone makes any difference.
Above all, I want my arms about you. Don't be a naughty baby. Papa, do my sweet embraceable you.
Okay, thanks, Blue Eyes. Okay, ladies and germs, next up is the piezo element one that I made. So let's try that. Put up the tone on it and see how that sounds.
I love all the many charms about you. Above all,
two out of the three. Okay, this is what the ceramic cartridge looks like. So let's put that in there for the final test. So let's see how this sounds.
Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Embrace me, my silk and laceable you. I'm in love with you, I am, and verily so. But you're much too shy, unnecessarily so.
Okay, now I'm gonna put the tone on. Try it.
I love all the many charms about you. Above all, I want my arms about you. Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Papa Doo, my sweet embraceable you.
Okay, so what do you think? I'm going to leave it up to you to decide. So when you leave a comment, please vote. Number one, the Shure original. Number two, the piezo element. Number three, the new ceramic cartridge. All right. Let's hear a little Frankie as we close out this episode.
Don't be a naughty baby. Come to Papa Doo.
See you next time.
My sweet.
This is Buzz.
Embrace.
Good night, ladies, wherever you are.
Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you.